The road to NHL success runs through small towns and big cities, literally across the globe, which is the reason the Bruins general manager finds himself rolling out of Montreal on an off day and heading east.
We got in late from Washington. Make sure we check on the schedule where Al might be headed to a game so that I can piggyback on with him to be able to go see one of our guys in Saboro and not too far away in Drummondville. I think in between games it's vitally important to utilize your time as effectively as possible. I got a chance to go in and see when we're in New York. I saw the Arizona play the Rangers. So I think it's important to be able to go see other teams as well as your own team. Stay connected with your prospects as best as possible.
Tonight, Sweeney and Quebec amateur scout Al Bissonnette will watch the St. John Sea Dogs take on the Drummondville Voltigeurs and see how one of the Bruins' first-round picks, Jacob Zboril, is doing. Zboril and his teammates come up short tonight, but he gets some quality FaceTime with the Bees GM after the game. A reminder that Boston is paying attention to the future as well as the present. The next night, another game for Don Sweeney to watch. Bees Habs at the Bell Center. 21-year-old Massachusetts native Frank Vetrano has been called up for this one and will make his NHL debut for the Bruins against Montreal. What could be better than that? But before Frank or anyone else in black and gold hits the ice, head coach Claude Julien outlines the keys to victory.
We can't afford to lose our heads, okay? But what we got to do is focus on our team here, go out there, have a good start, take it to them, and make it happen.
One way for a newcomer like Matt Beleski to join in on the Bruins-Canadiens rivalry, hit every blue, blanc, and rouge jersey you can.
Hey! Yeah, yeah. Grabbing everybody, baby.
What's up, Sammy? Dude?
Good, Matt.
Good shift, Frankie. Congrats, man.
Congrats,
man.
You made it.
Congrats.
Woo! Yeah!
Excited,
nice, kid.
That's real exciting. Oh! Kid.
I love it over here.
He does all this to bug people.
Put the f***ing puck in!
I think Frank is going to score right here.
He wins the draw.
If he wins the draw, I think he scored.
Shoot it! Yeah!
Woo! All right, can we to shoot the puck?
Hey, boy, Frank.
Yeah, I did. I'm good.
Wish I would have scored, though.
Vetrano's first career goal has the Bees up 2-1 after two. But closing out the Habs at home is tough. The Canadians tie it early in the third. Then a late penalty spells more trouble.
Trip over that little turtleneck? Jesus Christ.
The Habs ice it with an empty netter, and it's a tough loss that stretches the Bruins' losing streak to three. There is, however, one bright spot. Frank Vetrano, who grew up a Bees fan in East Longmeadow, Massachusetts, played his first game as a Bruin and scored a goal. Even better, his dad was here to see it.
What's up?
Hey, Frankie.
Where's my puck?
You got it.
You got it?
Yeah.
Hey, play great.
Thanks.
Is that awesome?
Now,
the first college goal, the first professional goal, and the first NHL goal, all within one calendar year.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
So proud of you. You played so good.
As the sun rises over New York City, the Boston Bruins find themselves in Brooklyn for an afternoon game against the Islanders. A late night arrival from Montreal and an early start time means no morning skate for the team. But in the quiet of a Sunday morning, a familiar face is back on the ice. Veteran defenseman Dennis Seidenberg underwent surgery for a herniated disc back in September and was projected to be out for 2 months. Now, 6 weeks into his recovery, Sides is happy to be practicing again.
Hard, hard, hard! Chip, chip!
Those tools are pretty fun. Quick stuff, quick shots. Should have done something like, if you miss it, you get some push-ups or a little bit more fun.
Number 44 isn't at 100% just yet, and he won't be playing in today's game. But a return to the lineup is drawing near. Just 18 hours after losing in Montreal, it's game time in Brooklyn. But no complaints and no excuses. Time for Max Talbot and the boys to end the losing streak.
Right, let's go here. Come on, Spoons, big draw, buddy. Win it. Give you 20 if you win it.
Arc out high to the top of the slot. Creates to the bottom of the left circle, but a back door, and Spooner scores!
Offense, Spoonsy, love it. Love it, Spoons.
No,
Zach.
Bye-bye, Dukes.
Take your time, you gotta go get your helmet there, so.
Better put it back on with that hair, dude. Oh, tough hair.
Tough hair.
Tough hair. Good job. Suck it, Lenny. Yes! Atta boy!
And then, yeah, woo!
2-0 Bruins heading into the third, thanks to a solid team effort and some great saves from Tuukka Rask. Oh, and Max Talbot's Movember mustache is also winning.
Thank you. Get out of here. Don't be bad, because my mustache is better.
You even grown yours longer.
A week?
Yeah.
Right, White. Atta boy. That's a big one. Dukes, you were sick, brother. You told me. Rich, sick job, buddy. Gus, you were not bad yourself.
Jimmy Hayes puts on a uniform and does his job every day. But as an American, and with Veterans Day approaching, he is looking to show his appreciation to some guys who do that on a more serious level, defending our nation.
Anything a soldier eats, touches, or carries, we do the science and technology, develop it for them.
Welcome to the U.S. Army's Soldier Research and Development Facility in Natick, Mass., where it's all about making sure our troops have the best of everything they need to do their jobs. And Jimmy is all in on this one.
Whoa! Oh.
This is food that the soldiers have to eat in the field, so if there's anywhere that the soldiers go, they have to be able to eat. You can, if you want, you can try
I'll
this.
I'll get it in there. All right. That looks tasty, though.
Yeah, that's a good one. It's teriyaki.
Oh.
We're going to go inside the chamber. We're going to let you go inside of the chamber. We're going to get a little bit of heat on for you, the treadmills and the solar lights, and we're going to get you motivated today. Are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm motivated.
After you.
All right, here we go.
When my girl was 97. She up, she died, she went to heaven.
All right, right on, boys.
I forsake not my country, my mission, my comrades, my sacred duties. I will live this, I am holy there, now and forever. I am the infantry, fall away!
Wow.
From the Boston Bruins and every one of us, a heartfelt thank you to all those brave men and women who have served and continue to serve. Ryan Spooner and the boys are looking to make it two wins in a row as they take the Garden Ice to face the Colorado Avalanche on Military Appreciation Night. And things look promising in the first few minutes of this one.
Goleski trying to get it away from the kick, and now here's Chara, he scores! Bruins have a 1-0 lead, a 1:12 in.
I didn't fan on it. I shot right along the ice. I was going to put up at first, and I saw his leg go up. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to hammer along the ice.
Unfortunately, the Bruins' lead evaporates as quickly as it came, and we're all tied going into the second period. Colorado's Landeskog gets that five-minute major, plus a game misconduct, and a two-game suspension for his hit on Marchand. But despite that and some strong work from Tuukka, the Bruins still cannot get it done tonight. The Avs win it 3-2, and the Bruins search for consistency continues. But win or lose, the Bees' evening does not end with the final whistle on Military Appreciation Night.
When people check me, sometimes. They can. Most of the time it's okay, though, because I wear pads, you know?
Kevin Miller, Hayes, Krejci, Krug, Trotman, and Marchand teamed up to donate $15,000 worth of tickets for the game to active duty members of the military, and are now taking some time to say thank you in person.
Thank you for coming, guys. Thank you for coming. Hi, how you doing? Absolutely.
We're good with that. How you doing?
It's obviously great to have them here, and it's great that we're able to give back a little bit. And, you know, we appreciate what they do for our country, our veterans, and our active duty military. It's it's something that I hold in high regard, and just glad I'm able to give something back. Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Thanks nice for coming, guys. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Game 16 of the regular season. Bruins wings. And another chance for the team to get back on track. Before puck drop, though, there is a moment to remember the victims of the Paris terrorist attack, and a reminder that there are things much bigger than hockey. Along with an opportunity to collect 2 points, this tilt will be Dennis Seidenberg's second game of the season after his return from injury.
Heads up! Heads up!
Despite the layoff, sides look solid on both ends of the ice. On the bench, however, there's still some rust showing.
Get one here, boys. Follow up here and kill it.
I mean, score. Can I go? Yeah? Oh.
With 44 and his teammates playing some great defense, the Bees ride 3 second period goals and a strong 60-minute effort to a 3-1 victory.
Hey, Spilding!
It's the week before Thanksgiving, and ready or not, that means the holiday season is upon us. And this year, Santa's helpers are going for a black and gold look.
So we got that for, this is 29.
I love it. I got it. Sorry. No worries. Bad hands. Years ago, Bruins captain Ray Bourque started the tradition of the team buying presents for kids who have to spend Christmas in local hospitals. Today, it's still going strong.
Aiden and Roman Reigns. Oh, yeah. Oh, 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 man, this is sick. That's a tag team champion.
You should put this in the room.
That's a world champion.
David Pastrnak is currently out with a foot injury and on crutches. There was some doubt whether he could participate today. But good news, turns out he can.
I'm on the crutches right now, so they put me in this nice car. I'm happy to be part of this event, you know, and help to found some gifts for the kids.
Buddy, I'm so jealous.
Yeah, right? I know. They see me rolling. Hello.
How fast are you going, David?
I don't know, like 2 miles an hour. Are we there soon? Sorry, guys, sorry. Good job, thanks, guys. Good job. You want to go check out Lego? Lego or whatever you call it? Oh my gosh, look at this one. Oh, there we are, hockey stick. All right, perfect. They see me rolling. Thank you. I want to tell you enjoy your holidays. It's a little early, but better early than never, huh?
The Boston Bruins have not won 2 games in a row since October. A strong performance in the win over Detroit sets the stage for tonight's matchup against the always dangerous San Jose Sharks. It'll be a tough task for Zach Rinaldo and the Bees tonight, and an early goal against only makes things more difficult.
Carlson, a wrist shot off the crossbar, and Pavelski scores! And the Sharks with an early lead, 42 seconds into the game.
Respond in here. Yeah, we respond, boys. Yeah. Yeah. Right. Right, Billy. I
bounce off someone and bounce off you.
Great.
Zach and the Bruins respond well to the Sharks' first goal, but there is a lot of hockey left to be played in this one. Tied at 3 in the second, a series of mistakes leads to this game unraveling for the Bruins. The too many men penalty helps open the door for San Jose, and suddenly, it's 5-3 Sharks. The Bees press in the third, but too little, too late. And it's another frustrating home loss for Boston. For NHL teams, the Thanksgiving holiday means more than turkey, stuffing, and football. It has become an important benchmark in the season. Usually those teams in the top 8 at Thanksgiving make the playoffs. Those that aren't, don't. The Bruins currently sit in the middle of the pack. Time will tell if this Thanksgiving trend continues to hold true.